Side of that. That's the big continent. Oh shit! Hey, I was talking to my friends. Yeah. Oh, I was like, what's causing the boom booms? Alright, there's no reason for you guys to be down here, literally.
But my difficulty. Delicious ammos.
Ammos. Kill the big tentacle. Stop shooting me with little tentacles. Usually we're fans of tentacles here, but you guys are not being conducive to victory.
They're kind of pushing the limit.
You should. You still there? Did I get you? Yes, I got him.
I think you got him.
For you. Turns for me.
Thank you, Isaac. I always believed in you.
Nicole?
I knew you'd return to me. We are whole again, Isaac. We are whole.
Hey, the sun dries and I can't see you. Nicole? Ah! It's supposed to go back to the ship.
That's ominous.
Oh, there's still one.
Your orbital gravity
tab is offline.
Oh, yeah.
Tentacle load release.
Evacuate this area immediately.
So, yeah, that big... See how it's all heating up now? It's
about to re-enter,
Gravity's saying, hey, why don't you come on back down?
gravity be, you know, gravity got a gravity, man. Gravity got a pull.
What is this room again? The, turn. Oh, right, so I get out of here. Ah! What the? Huh?
You made it.
Oh, this is a decam. Hey! What?
What? You don't believe me?
No.
Take a look at yourself. Very good. Take a look at the video from the call. And this time, watch your legs again.
Isaac, it's me. I wish I could talk to you. I'm sorry. I'm sorry about everything. I wish I could just go talk to someone. It's all falling apart here. I can't believe what's happening. It's strange. It's a little thing. And then it all comes down to one little thing. I didn't want it to end like this. I really wanted to see you again. Just once. I loved you. I always loved you.
Talk to you. No, I want come. I want come back. I want to talk to you.
Shit. Her stasis module can't be as good as ours, though. Like, she hasn't got any power nodes all game.
No. She'll have no Isaac Clarke action engineer suit. Got something on your arm there, Isaac. Can I leave now? So, yeah. Nicole's been dead the whole time.
No!
No way that the in-game exposition didn't just explain that. I want to know what she shot up, though. Is that, like, heroin?
No, she injected herself with something to commit suicide.
Nah. I really pity that. Hey, those air vents. That's scary. Oh, look, a power node.
Because, she saw what was going on in the Ishimura, and she didn't see a way out. So, instead of, you know, waiting for the necromorphs to come and get her, she just took care of herself. That doesn't sound good.
Sure doesn't.
But can I say it again? Fuck Kendra.
Yeah. Fuck Kendra.
Seems appropriate now.
So, casting aside pretense, welcome to the boss fountain.
Yes.
Ammunition. Is there a save point in here?
I bet you there's going to be a save point and a store.
Well, there's a store and a engineering thing. Yeah, there it is. These guys are all still hanging around. Yeah, there's a store. So let's double check. Whew! Ruby. got a bajillion stasis packs.
I have a feeling you're not going to need all of those.
I really don't need... Whoops. Plasma energy, contact energy, mind axe. Okay, so I do need...
The irony, we've been complaining for the past several episodes about contact energy and
yeah,
now we're buying a bunch.
The irony, because they are actually pretty useful for what's coming up. And one for the road. Alright. Charge would have been the best addition I did there. There's no reason to do my rig.
Yeah, you better get enough. You have to go get new HP.
Well, my spine. Poof!
Hooray.
So many spine segments.
So much more spine.
Maximum over spine.
Maximum over spine.
Save point.
Save. There we go.
Now we gotta fuck Kendra's day up.
Maggie Kendra is our final boss.
Oops, that's not the way I wanted. You guys wait here, I'll be right back.
Kendra!
Oh, Kendra. Hey, those things weren't there before. Whoops, wrong button. Here we go. Did I get that from here before we start this up?
Hey, did we say fuck Kendra yet?
Oh my. Oh my dear. That was kinda
fuck Kendra.
That was kinda tentacle rape.
A little bit.
And,
can you just like bro fist whatever this creature is and then leave?
Oh, look at all the Xboxes he just dredged up.
Hey! Thanks for killing Kendra.
Here we go.
You look kind of weird. I'm gonna go.
Oh my god.
Action. See you.
Oh, you popped a zit.
He's got a few more. Ow.
That hurt.
Up there. name. Let me go. Let me go. Ow.
I don't think that's quite what you wanted.
Grab my gun.
Smooth little like toss of the fire.
I thought it was gonna go farther than that. Come on, bob and weave, bob and weave. Come on, come on, you got nothing on me. You've nothing. You've nothing. Nothing but big dead nothing. Come on. Come on, show me your goods.
Yeah. Look at those two dangling chest appendages.
Chesticles?
Yeah.
But not the good kinds? Give me that one. Bomb weave, bomb weave. Nope, nope.
Come on. Again, roll 34 applies.
Ah,
here.
Fuck! Ow! I'm not dead, I'm not dead. Heal up. Oh, invisibility frames my friend. It's throwing shit at me. Good buddy. God damn it. Fuck you.
Should have never fucked with Isaac Clarke, action engineer. Up the ramp.
Just double flipping him off, like, get the fuck out of here! I am done! And look, he just books it now. Oh shit! There's a continent falling on us! Oh.
There you go.
Fuck the marker. Watch how fast the ship takes off.
It's a going.
Whoosh!
Oh! There goes Ishimura.
No, that was the continent. There it goes. Oh, it's so pretty. Oh, shit!
Boom.
And there goes the planet.
Planet cracked.
You know, the sometimes when a man just has to say one thing to define his life. Fuck Kendra. Oh, my face. I'm gonna go home and take some aspirin, and I'm gonna sleep for 2 weeks.
Isaac, come in here. I wish I could talk to you.
Stop.
I'm a sad man.
Dead space! Yay!
Hooray! Hooray! Look at those credits.
So, oh man, so much stuff. So, I talked about ways right at the beginning that there was a kind of a quote-unquote a secret about all the titles for all the chapters.
Uh-huh.
I forgot to list them all out, but if you list all the chapters out and you put all the first letter of all their names together, it spells out Nicole is dead.
Huh.
So it just kind of drops to you the
hint.
The hint that, yeah, she's dead. There's kind of some inconsistencies about some of the lore here because, every time Isaac saw Nicole on the Ishimura, it was supposed to be a ghost. And the thing about Dead Space and people that are being influenced by the marker is they'll see hallucinations of dead loved ones, either like, you know, family members or people that they liked a lot.
Right.
In every other form of the media I've seen when they do that, except in the games, the people are like, they literally look like ghosts. Like, they're blue and see-through and they talk like ghosts.
Right.
Obviously, they changed it in the game so it wouldn't be revealed to the player until the end when you saw the whole movie that Nicole is dead. But then there's the interesting segment, if you guys remember back when Nicole had to open the door for you.
Right.
And you had to protect her from the necromorphs.
Uh-huh.
That whole scenario is like, how is that happening?
Right.
Because it's literally, she's physically altering a machine to let you in a door. And then there's also some speculation about why the necromorphs would be attacking her when she's a hallucination. Because the hallucinations, they start out like in the early lore and like in the comic I was talking about. They always talk about how important the marker is.
Right.
And the marker should be left alone.
Yeah.
There was some theorizing going on that the marker on Aegis 7 anyways kind of had two properties. Now, the property that would like raise the dead as necromorphs. But then there was another property that was put into it that was like a failsafe. Mm-hmm. That it would drive people to, if the marker was ever removed, to put the marker back.
Oh, okay.
However, that tendency never really shows up again in any of the other games when there's marker shenanigans going on. Mm-hmm. The marker in Aegis 7 was destroyed, but its legacy, I'll say, because there was a movie that they made after this called Dead Space Aftermath.
Right.
And it's really cool. It was done like in the vein of like the Halo and like the Animatrix,
right,
where it's a bunch of shorts that are all like done in different animation stuff.
Oh, nice.
It talks about what happens directly after this. Aegis 7 doesn't explode. It's like really messed up. And a crew goes there. They get hired by somebody to go to Aegis 7 and keep it stable long enough for another team to find a piece of the marker.
Oh.
The marker from Aegis 7. And then that starts an outbreak on that ship that goes there. The thing is the whole thing about someone trying to fix the situation never appears in that situation. It just starts a necromorph outbreak and things go to hell.
Right.
It's still really cool, though. It's kind of mentions how Isaac ends up where he does at the start of 2. Spoiler-esque, if we ever get around doing a 2 Dead Play, which I'd like to do sometime, Isaac starts in a mental institution. Because what you saw right there, that wasn't actually a necromorph. When I first played this game, I thought that was a necromorph in Nicole's body.
And he's
dead.
That
had found a way. And then there was the big... That was like, oh shit, is he dead? What's going on? And then when they got closer, like when 2 was announced, they were talking about details of 2. They said, no, Isaac, due to his experiences with the marker on Ishimura and Aegis 7, he's insane.
Right.
His mind is tainted. He still sees hallucinations. And they put him in a mental hospital for other reasons as well. I won't go into in case we ever do a playthrough of 2. But not too bad.
Yeah.
As I talked about before, there's some other really good stuff with Dead Space. Dead Space 3 is kind of where the series like kind of trotted off and might be the reason we never see another Dead Space game again. I hope they do another one someday, but other good stuff, like I said, the comic, it's called Dead Space as well.
Right.
And if you guys want to watch it sometime, we can watch it on YouTube. It's really cool. It's like an hour long. Because when they released Dead Space, they actually had an actual comic. I can't remember the name of the artist, but it's really grainy art style and kind of messy. But
right.
It goes like on with this, like where it's going and what's going to happen.
Okay.
And then, like during the the pre-release stuff of Dead Space. Game trailers had an episodic release of that comic in video form. I was like, oh, I'll watch this. It'd be kind of like to read the comic. And like there were, as I talked about before, they voiced it over. Like they take out all the dialogue on the pages, and like the characters kind of move around a little bit every once in a while. But it's just like
gotcha.
The comic, like that's talking. It's really cool.
Nice.
And that talks about the events on Aegis 7 where they discover the marker.
Right.
And to talk about that a little bit, the marker in this is a marker that was created by the Earth Federation.
Right.
After studying the original marker that was found on Earth, that was called the Black Marker, and that was the founding of Unitology. Earth studied that. They came to Aegis 7 for experiments. They recreated the marker. Shit went down, not good stuff. So they used the marker to seal what you saw, what I thought was the hive mind.
Right.
And then they cordoned off and they made that whole section no fly. Well, about 200 years later, here comes the CEC Corporation looking for planets to mine for resources.
Right.
And like, ooh, Aegis 7 looks pretty. And they stumble upon the marker. And sadly, the events of the comic goes down. It shows the marker. That's kind of cool. That's kind of a little bit of foreshadowing how you saw it was all in the alien language about how Isaac is now kind of not in his right mind so much anymore. Oh, this is all New Game Plus stuff.
Right.
Impossible mode unlocked. Sure, I'll save my progress. Why not? The keep getting trailing off here. The comic talks about, like I said, they discover the marker on the planet. It shows how stuff went to shit on the planet itself, Aegis 7.
Mm-hmm.
The Ishimura does show up. They do the planet crack. And like I said, the Newman guy that was in the video log, he's kind of the main character of that.
Right.
There's another movie called Dead Space Downfall, which is another prequel that shows, it's from the perspective of a security officer, I can't remember her name, on the Ishimura. And it kind of explains how the infection got from the planet to the Ishimura. Mm-hmm. And how shit went down on the Ishimura right before Isaac and crew show up.
Gotcha. Okay.
There's also some novels that talk about like stuff like way in the past, like when Unitology was first founded, and the truth about Altman, who was kind of quote unquote the prophet of Unitology.
Right.
I haven't read any of them though. Another good thing to talk about. But yeah, Dead Space, good stuff. I like Dead Space a lot. It's one of my favorite franchises. I really hope it comes back someday. Really hope we can get to do some other playthroughs of like 2 and then 3. If we do 2, there's also a prequel thing I got that we play beforehand. I think it's called Dead Space Extraction.
Yeah.
That explains, I think, we'll play that first, because the way 2 starts, it shows a dude rescuing Isaac, and it's kind of that dude's backstory to how he got there.
Right. Okay.
But yeah, we'll do that someday, and then maybe even 3. But yeah. Dead Space, any parting words, Logan?
Nope.
Dead Space is dead.
Nightmare fuel for you for some time?
Nah, it's been all right. Like I said, you give these things names, and they become infinitely less frightening.
They become people again.
So what's the name of the hive mind?
Hive mind Harry.
Bob.
Fair
His
enough.
Name's Bob.
All right, guys.
Bob and Weave.
Bob and Weave. Bob and Weave.
Bob and Weave.
I'm going to call him Apollo. Hive mind name is now Apollo.
No, he should be Adonis.
No.
Adonis Paulo?
No.
No.
No. No.
All right, guys. Catch you later.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star. How I wonder what you are. Up above the world.